If you're going to be confident, if you're going to be independent, if you're going to be defiant, if you're going to be solitary, if you're going to be divergent, if you're going to be an ubermensch like Napoleon Bonaparte, who may well have been an overman, he said, impossible is a word to be found only in the dictionary of fools. So too for you, quitting is for cowards. That's what your mindset is. You will not be stopped. You will not be inhibited by any obstacle that comes your way. You're going to keep going, and nothing and nobody is going to inhibit you from your ideals. Never. Never. You're not going to be an ideologue, a boring person who just can say one sentence and then your whole ideology politically can be guessed. You're going to have an ideal, like Alexander comparing himself to the mythological hero Achilles, and then you're going to surpass the ideal. That's how you're going to exist on this planet. Now, things won't always pan out as you're expecting. Matilda might come to London in the 12th century against King Stephen, and the fact is she may demand harsh tribute more than any king before. You may find yourself in the Bolshevik Revolution, which won against the Mensheviks, and Joseph Stalin and Trotsky are under the leadership of Vladimir Lenin, who achieves cult-like status. And sure, he has to take one step backward to democracy, to take two steps forward to really hit communism, hit the gas pedal with communism. And sure, he had his brain sliced up into 30,963 pieces to see what the brain of a genius really looked like, but the whole movement didn't work. 9 million people died. Do you see what I'm saying? Like, it didn't work. The country lay in tatters. And then Joseph Stalin, who, by the way, Vladimir Lenin gave Joseph Stalin a supreme place in government, a high place in government, and yet at the end he's like, he's too rude, which is fine among us communists, but dealing with other people, he's not going to work. He should be removed from government. He should be removed from this position of office. But Stalin didn't want that read out loud. He didn't want the comments and manifesto of Stalin read out of Lenin read out loud, because Stalin was not given the full support of Lenin, and things didn't go exactly as he wanted. In fact, Lenin, for the next 30 years, would establish his rule after Lenin died and gave Trotsky the wrong date for Lenin's funeral. So now he himself, Stalin, the man of steel, was the one in power for the next three decades. And then things didn't go as planned. Like, the Bolshevik Revolution ended up being a disaster. Things don't always go as panned out in history. Like, that's what we find in studying history. The one thing we learn from history is that we don't, as it's been said. So yeah, things don't go as planned always. What are you going to do? Are you going to cry? Are you going to whine? Are you going to be greater? Are you going to be stronger? Are you going to be more independent? And are you going to be more courageous? And are you going to be more defiant? Because that's how a hope, yoke, theosophia overman lives, with the numenology written on his heart. He does not give up. She does not give in.